My last video was really cool. I was unboxing these beautiful imported bettas. I had cool shots, I had beautiful fish. This video isn't nearly as cool. It's about teeny tiny little itty bitty water bugs. Not all my videos can be cool. You gotta take the good with the bad here. Hey guys, Simply Betta here. I cannot raise Daphnia. I'm a Daphnia murderer. I slay entire cultures all at once, and I don't even try. I keep a lot of live food cultures for my fish and for my lizards. It's just something that I enjoy doing. I like raising all these little bugs. I don't really know why it's so interesting to me. One thing that I've tried several times now is to raise Daphnia and have a culture of Daphnia, which are these tiny little water bugs, essentially, that are very commonly raised for feeding baby fish, especially bettas. They're a very commonly kept live food resource for people all over the world who raise betta fish. And I've really wanted to have like a little culture at home that I could just take care of and pull from, and I've tried three times now, three separate occasions to do one, and I keep failing. I keep doing great for a while, and then a couple weeks later, I've just killed everything, and I'm really sad about it. But I have like this three strikes you're out policy with trying new things and failing at them. But I tried Daphnia three times, and the third time I was like, all right, this is the last time, I'm gonna try really hard again. And sure enough, I botched it somehow, and I just gave up. And I told myself, I am never gonna try Daphnia ever again. So what am I doing today, guys? I am trying Daphnia one more time. Just one more time. One last time. And then I can give up if I fail. But I'll try not to fail. I'll try really hard. Why am I trying it a fourth time? Well, I was rooting around in my fridge, just cleaning it out a little while ago, and I discovered something. A packet. And in this packet are Daphnia cysts, which are like Daphnia eggs. I got this because I wanted to experiment with it a little while ago. I bought some Daphnia eggs or cysts to try to hatch them and see what happened. And I completely forgot about it. And this little thing's just been sitting in my fridge. So I think today I'm going to try Daphnia one last time. And since I'm gonna be trying Daphnia again, I figured, hey, why not try something similar to Daphnia too? This is called moina, another commonly raised little tiny water bug that's supposed to be a little hardier, a little less prone to crashing than Daphnia, but we'll see if that's true, because I'm great at crashing Daphnia cultures, so I should also be great at crashing a moina culture. Let's make these. So this is the envelope that has the Daphnia eggs in it. Let's open it up and see how to hatch these things. Here's the little baggie right here, and then it came with instructions. Now I've never hatched Daphnia eggs before, so I'm gonna follow these instructions exactly. Whoa, okay. That's a lot of instructions. Step one, you need a clean jar and don't use soap to wash it. Got a clean jar right here. Two, use distilled RO or carbon filtered water for the highest hatching rate. I made myself some RO water, also known as reverse osmosis water. This is pretty much pure H2O. Step B, place the jar near a window because you want some sunlight, 1 to 2 hours of direct sunlight daily. I don't have any windows that get direct sunlight in this time of year, but it says you can use a 100 watt bulb right on top of the jar if sunlight is unavailable. I'm gonna have to do that. Step three is you actually pour the eggs into the jar and then fill it up half with water. And then add more water after 2 hours. Okay. Do not move the jar when hatching the eggs. All right, okay, I'll open up my little baggie of bug eggs, pour it in. I'm wearing my braces again because my wrists are kind of bugging me. I think it's from holding my very heavy baby all day. Okay, got those eggs in. I'm gonna go move this to a spot below a lamp and put the water in. I put the jar down in the place where it's going to stay until the eggs hatch, under a lamp, which I'm pretty sure is gonna be bright enough. And I added half the water. I follow these instructions exactly, so there's no reason why this should not work. Siri, set a timer for 2 hours.
Your timer is set for 2 hours.
In 2 hours, I'll add the rest of the water. It says it can take 3 to 5 days for these Daphnia to hatch, and they'll hatch for like over a week. And then once I see them, feed them with some baker's yeast. Then I can put them into my own ponds or tanks after they hatch. Right on. So we'll see if I manage to mess this up. I'm excited. I hope this works. As for the species of Daphnia, I'm pretty sure this is Pulex. It's not the big old like the magnas. They're a smaller species, I think. Now that those Daphnia are done and hopefully that they're gonna work, time to try the moina. Okay, so the moina came with some little pellets. I assume this is spirulina tablets as a food source, probably. Pipette. Can't get enough pipettes. I love pipettes. And here's a little tiny capsule. The eggs are probably inside. And the instructions. Start with a clean container. Check. Use aged, distilled, or rainwater. Well, I'm gonna use RO water, which is essentially distilled water. Pure water. You need a light source, which I'm gonna use that desk lamp. So it says to put the capsule of moina eggs into 1 liter of the water. They'll begin to hatch in 24 to 72 hours. And after about a week, you can put them into your own containers or feed cultures with them. I went and I got some more RO water. Pour in about a liter. I think that's about a liter. I'll take my little capsule, which is wrapped in tin foil. It looks like I'm buying illegal things in the mail. Little do they know. It's just some nerdy little bugs. So I'm gonna open it up and... These guys hatched. The Daphnia did really good. The Moina didn't do nearly as well. But I had these for a couple months just trying to grow the populations and feed them and put them into different containers and tubs with bigger water volumes. And I put a good amount of effort into it. Of course, I didn't record any footage of that. If you've been waiting for the results of this months-long experiment, if you've been waiting to find out if I can keep Daphnia alive, I'm here to tell you that I have absolutely 100% failed. Failed! Failed again. I managed to hatch the Daphnia, I managed to hatch the Moina, and I kept them alive for a while, and I kept trying to grow their little populations, and I kept losing lots of them, and I was never able to keep them. What's wrong with me? I don't think I am meant to keep Daphnia. That was my fourth try, my fourth honest attempt to keep these bugs, and I failed. So that means I'm not gonna try anymore. And I think I've managed to prove to the world that I cannot keep Daphnia alive. Instead, I'm just gonna rely on my terrestrial worm cultures to be my main live food for my adult bettas, which is my grindle worms, my white worms, and then for my baby bettas, I'm gonna keep relying on using vinegar eels and microworms and baby brine shrimp, and that's what works for me. That's what's easy for me. I can keep these things just in the back of my mind and just forget about them and not have to upkeep them and do just fine. So I'm not gonna try Daphnia anymore. And I'm okay with it. So if you ever see me about to try again, just tell me to just not do it. Thanks so much for watching, guys. Daphnia are not meant to be kept by everybody. If you've had success keeping these guys, because I'm sure there's plenty of people out there who've had a lot of success, go ahead and share what you've done down below in the comments. So that way, people who want to try keeping Daphnia or who've been failing a lot, like me, they can read that and maybe try again. But I'm not going to, because I think I've proven to the world that I'm terrible. Thanks so much for watching, guys. Be sure to like and subscribe and have a great day.